You know what you're here for? I know what I'm here for. Come on now, do it with me, please. I'm telling you, your video will hit 10 times harder. It's all part of a bigger plan, this video. Now we're back in the present moment. My king, my queen, now you. Yes, you, not anybody else, but they could join in if they want to. You can sit back and relax. My soul is positive energy and positive content onto your family. Hold up, can I get a right side? What? Left side. Take this positive energy. Boom. Woo! Do y'all feel the vibes? I know I feel the vibes. I know y'all do too. Now, there's usually something. Hold up. I just gotta thank y'all. I appreciate you clicking on my video, because you don't have to. You can exit out right now if you wanted to. I'd like you to stay, because I got some good stuff to talk about, but I appreciate you. I'm not entitled to your time. You're not entitled to mine. I appreciate you so much. Now, there's usually something I do in the beginning of my videos, like, man, what could it be? What could it possibly be? Oh, yeah. How can we forget to express some gratitude real quick? Come on now. Breathe with me again. It's for a bigger purpose. Let's take a moment to express some gratitude real quick. And remember, you got to breathe in gratitude, breathe out. No entitlement. I do that daily and it helps a lot. Now, we got to take a moment to be grateful. Do you want to know why we got to be grateful? Because the sun's out. Because we have our hands. We have all our fingers. We could have these or these. No hands. We have our arms, our legs. We have nature around us. We have the beautiful bright sun shining on us. We have vision. We can hear. We can speak. We have clothing, clothes that you like. Not just some raggedy old clothes. Clothes are clothes, but still, it's stuff you like. And also, more importantly, we got to see today. We got to see this Monday right now. If you hate Mondays, after I say this to you, you will never hate Mondays again. Because you got to realize, some people passed yesterday on a Sunday, and they didn't know last Monday was the last Monday they were ever going to see in their whole entire life. Hold up, can I get a right side? What? Left side. Take this positive energy. Boom. Woo-wee. Did you feel that? I know you did. Now, you gotta realize we're not entitled to today. We're not entitled to tomorrow. I'm not entitled to the next 10 minutes of my life. This is why we have to be appreciate every single moment and be grateful and stay in that present moment. Because when we're in the present mode, we're not worried about the past where anxiety, fear comes about. And we're not worried about the future where we can get too worried, too anxious. We're about the present moment. We're happy. Now, also, with your gratitude, right? I want y'all to do something very, 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 very important to you right now. I need y'all to touch your heart. Touch your heart right now. Not on the right side. You're not an alien or nothing. Touch the left side of your heart, right? Well, touch your heart in general. Your heart, you feel that heartbeat? Your heart beats approximately 4,800 times per hour. Every single time you touch your heart and you feel boom, boom, boom. Let that heartbeat be a token of gratitude and love. To say like, damn, my heart's beating right now. I'm alive. I'm grateful. Let it be a token of gratitude. And your heart beats a lot throughout the day, so every single time, boom. You have like, you didn't have a limited amount of tokens of gratitude. Now, also, you just gotta think. You just gotta thank Allah, Jah, God, the universe, Jesus Christ, whatever higher power or religious power you believe in. Even if you don't believe in any higher power at all, because ain't nothing wrong with that. You do you. Do what makes you happy. You just gotta thank God, thank the universe, whatever. And just in general, be grateful to see today because you're not entitled to it. Now, also with being grateful, you gotta think about it. You sleep in a bed, right? A nice warm cozy bed, you have all these utilities, all that stuff. But the thing is, there's people who sleep under bridges, sleep on park benches, sleep on bus stop benches. There's people who go and sleep outside of buildings. There's people who don't know where they're going to sleep tonight. You feel me? This is why you have to be grateful. This is why you have to be grateful for those things. Because you're not entitled to any bed. You could go home right now and then boom. Guess what happens? You lose your bed. Your bed's not there. You're not entitled to your bed. Be grateful for your bed, man. Please be grateful for your bed now also. To go and talk about entitlement, right? And being grateful. You have to be thankful for your water. Your water? I know what you're probably thinking. It's just water, right? Because water is so we can get it so easy. But the thing is, water is very scarce in the world if you actually don't know. Because we could pour out, because in India, right, there are 300 million people who do not have running water. Hey, Carson. A video. My little brother. We could pour out, not pour out, my bad, here we are. There are 300 million people in the world who do not have water, right? Out of 300 million people in the world, you have water. Isn't that crazy? They don't have any running water, but yeah, you have running water in your house. You have those utilities of heat, electricity, running water, stability, you have a home. Those people don't have those things. Be grateful for those things because you're not entitled to them. Also, with your running water, right? The people in India, the water they have to drink, imagine getting a cup of water, right, and you just dump a pile of mud in it. Boom, just like that. That's the water they have to drink. You don't want to drink that, but you don't have to. Aren't you grateful? Some people in countries have to walk 5 miles just to get clean water. Not even clean water, water that's like barely clean. Aren't you grateful for that? Aren't you grateful that you don't have to do that? You have so much water, you can fill up a tub with the water, still have plenty of water left over. You have so much water, you can pour out 5 water bottles worth of water right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Still got plenty of water left over. You got so much water that you can bathe with it, drink it, cook with it, wash your dog with it, wash your car with it, have fun with it like a water balloon fight, like a water gun fight. You have so much water. This is why you gotta be grateful, man. You gotta be grateful now that we got the gratitude out the way. I'm explaining to y'all why I want y'all to breathe with me and express gratitude. You're probably thinking, huh, why does King want to do that? Well, my King or Queen watching this, I did that to get y'all into my formula of happiness. That being P plus G equals H. P plus G equals H, what's that? Let me tell you real quick. P plus G equals H is the present moment plus gratitude equals happiness. Hold up, can I get a right side, what? Left side, take this positive energy, boom. Because when you're in the present moment, expressing gratitude, there's no way you cannot be happy. You could try as hard as you want to not be happy, but you will fail. Because 99% of the time, you will be happy. There might be that 1%. You have to try extra hard. There's just no way you cannot be happy when you're in the present moment expressing gratitude. Now, enough chit-chat, enough talk, enough said. Let's get that throat chakra going. Let's get right into this video. For y'all that have stayed this far, I appreciate you so much. And also, I want y'all to comment one thing you are grateful for. You know, just express some gratitude. And let me know how you're doing in the comment section down below. And subscribe if you're new, because we're on the road to impacting 1 million people to be positive, mindful, grateful, and overall the best version of themselves. You don't have to subscribe, though. I'm not entitled to it. It's your choice. Not entitled to it at all. Now, the title of this video is, don't let your ego blind you. And I write, all my stuff comes from here. It comes from my mind. I write it on here. Crazy. Don't let your ego blind you. Ego. The definition of ego is a person's sense of self-esteem or self-importance. We all have an ego, whether we use it for bad or good purposes. We all have one, and there is no denying it, especially in today's world. There are a lot of people getting blinded by their ego to make themselves feel bigger or that something they are doing is okay when it's really not okay. Our ego is part of us, so most of the time we are unaware of it, and furthermore unaware when we are getting blinded by it. And when we get blinded by it, we don't even realize that we're blocking blessings from coming into our life. For instance, we often get blinded by our ego when we see something sweet like chocolate or ice cream, right? Something we know we shouldn't have, but our ego says, you deserve it. Oh, it's fine. It won't hurt you. When you know you're supposed to be on a diet and you're not supposed to have any sweets, your ego is telling you, saying, oh, that piece of chocolate cake sitting in that window, you should go get that. Really? I don't want that. But your ego is saying, oh, it's okay. You're getting blinded by your ego to think that it's okay to eat that chocolate when you know you're not supposed to have it. 1 second. Here we are. All right. Also, for example, drinking, right? Let's say you're trying to get rid of your drinking problems, right? And you go and say, man, I've been sober for like a whole month now. And your friend comes over and he's drinking a beer, right? I don't drink, but I'm just using this as an example. Your friend drinking beer, right? And then your ego is telling you, man, you know, you've been doing a good job. One little beer won't hurt. When in the back of your subconscious mind, you know you're not supposed to have any. But your ego is blinding you to think that it's okay for you to have a beer when it's not okay for you to have one. Now, let me turn the page real quick, y'all. I hope you're enjoying the video so far. Thank you for staying. Now, this brings me to the thought of how our ego comes up a lot during arguments, and it blinds us. Screen record this or something, because this part is going to really hit different. For instance, we typically argue with someone, like our significant other or loved ones, and we will almost every time get blinded by our ego and try to get the last words. Hold up, can I get a right side? What? Left side. Take this positive energy. Boom. Woo. Because doesn't that happen a lot? Don't you try to get the last word in the argument a lot just to make yourself feel better, to feed your ego? Or, not even the last words too. Or we say something hurtful without being mindful of it too. Yes sir, can I get a left side this time? Right side, take this positive energy. Boom. Woo! Now, when it comes to arguments, we must not argue to win, but argue to come to a better understanding. Hold up. I gotta get it again. Can I get a left side? What? Right side, take this positive energy. Boom. Woo! Let me say that again. When it comes to arguments, we must not argue to win, but argue to get a better understanding. No right or wrong, just a better understanding for both sides. We must not bring up past wounds to hurt again, but bring up past wounds to heal them again. Can I get a right side? What? Left side. Take this positive energy. Boom. Woo, spy by Ralph Smart right there. Yes, sir. Always, I need y'all to listen, really listen to this and digest it. Always be mindful of arguing, because that could be the... Okay, I need y'all to listen to this, right? Always be mindful of when you're having an argument or something like that, because you don't realize this, but let's say you go and you're having an argument with your mother, with your mom, right? And then you argue with your mom You argue with your mom right when she's about to leave to work. You don't know that that could be the last time you see your mom. And the last memory you are going to have is you arguing with your mother and being hateful and not being loveful. Because you got to realize, I need y'all to do this. Next time you're arguing with your mother or anybody, right? I need y'all to just come to a better understanding instead of trying to win the argument or have any last words. Because you don't know if that could be the last time you see that person or anything like that. That's why you gotta always leave off on a good note instead of trying to leave off on the last words. Hold up, can I get a right side? What? Left side, take this positive energy. Boom. Woo! Always try to leave off on a good note instead of trying to leave off on the last words. Yes, sir. I'm definitely clipping that. Now, to continue on from this. Furthermore, this brings us to the example of how our ego can feed our procrastination. I know everybody can relate to this one. Our ego can tell us, just do it tomorrow. We deserve to relax when we know we need to get it done. And before we know it, it will be too late for us to start or finish it. Allow me to... Hang on. Because y'all guys realize, like, for example, if you got homework or something, you guys say, oh, I could do it tomorrow. And then guess what? The deadline comes. Oh, damn. You can't turn it in anymore. Our ego was just keep telling us, oh, we got time. Oh, this, let's relax. Do it tomorrow. No. You know what's right from what's... You know right from wrong. Don't let your ego blind you, my king or queen. Now, where was I? Allow me to share my own ego experience where I really became aware of my ego. And I'm still becoming aware of my ego to this day, right? So, for example, I went and I say this is about happening in October 2019. In October 2019, I was in such a comfort space. I was still being positive, but like, I would have liked to go out to places. I would have liked to go. I would have liked to go and just talk to strangers or anything like that, right? And I would be in a bubble, this bubble of comfort. And that I was so blinded to my ego that I wouldn't even realize that it's happening. I'll be so blinded to it. Until one day, I was sitting in my bed. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm in a comfort zone. This isn't good. My ego was blinding me the whole time, and I was thinking in my ego state. But there is one thing that helped me with this, and this is what Steve Harvey said. Steve Harvey went and told me, because I was looking at ways to get, I was looking at ways to help with this. And Steve Harvey went and said, ordinary people like comfort, and you're not ordinary. Just like how you're watching this video, you're not an ordinary person. You're a, say it with me, extraordinary person. Take this positive energy, boom, woo. Hold up, let me see if there's anything else I had to add for that part. We are not ordinary people, but we are extraordinary people. As I just said, because you got to realize, comfort is something we are blinded to a lot by our ego. In the moment where you're like, oh my gosh, it just, it hits you crazy. Now, lastly, I have this example by a great guru. Lastly, I want to mention a story from Guru Gopal Das. I hope I'm saying his name right. His name is spelled G-A-U-R-G-O-P-A-L Das, and there's spaces in between them. Guru Gopal Das was talking about how he was, also, before I mention that, right, y'all seen that experience I shared with you about my ego. I'm not better than anybody. My life's not perfect, but I try to think in a positive perspective. If I can go and get out of my comfort zone and come to realization with my ego and have that self-awareness, what's stopping you from doing that? I'm no different from you. You're no different from me. If I can do it, you can do it too, my king or queen. Take this positive energy. Boom. Woo, you hear the birds? They know I'm spinning facts. Now, where was it? Oh, yeah. This guru was talking about how he didn't speak to his father for 2 years because of a incident he had with him where they had different opinions. Because he felt that he was right. Oh, hang on one second. 2 years, he felt that he was right, right? Eventually, his mother got him to speak to his father again. But he eventually picked up not speaking to his father again and picked up on those bad habits. But this time, it was too late and his father passed away. He didn't speak to his father for a very long time and his father passed away. Man, and Guru Gopal Das had said something that really resonated with my soul. And he went and said, when you say you're sorry, it doesn't mean you're wrong. Hold up, can I get a, right side, what? Left side, take this positive energy, boom. Woo! When you say you're sorry, it does not mean you're wrong. And his explanation to elaborate on this more was, all it means is that you value the person in their relationship more than being right. You value the person in their relationship more than being right. Can I get a, right side, what? Left side, take this positive energy, boom. Woo! Also, he also said, you have to choose. What do you want? He also said, you have to choose, what do you want more? Being right or being loved? Very wise words from Guru Gopal Das. Now, the video's about to end, but I got some quotes for y'all in my outro. All in all, we must try our very best not to allow our ego to block the... We must try our very best not to allow our ego to block the blessings that are coming our way, my king, my queen. Practicing self-awareness is a very good way to, one moment, to become a better version of ourselves. Now, I got three quotes for y'all that will help and resonate with y'all very much. Quote number one, don't let your ego block the blessings from coming your way. As I said again, can I get a, right side, what? Left side, take this positive energy, boom. Woo, because you don't even realize something very like life-changing, very like good could like about to be happening in your life. But just because you're living in your ego, it's just blocking that blessing for coming in on you. Blocking that life-changing opportunity for coming in on you because you're living in your ego. Now, quote number two, when you say you're sorry, it does not mean you're wrong. Can I get a... right side, what? Left side, take this positive energy, boom. When you say you're sorry, it does not mean you're wrong. All it means is that you value the person in their relationship more than being right. And also that, to add on to that, I got four quotes now. Quote number three, always don't try to leave off on the last words in an argument. Try to leave off on a good note in the argument, because you need to know when the last time you're going to see that person or individual may be. You don't know when the last time you're going to see that person is, basically. Hold on, can I get a, for that, can I get a, Left side this time. The right side takes its positive energy. Boom. Woo. Now, quote number four. Do not allow your ego to get the best of you. Instead, allow yourself to get the best of your ego. You are in control. Hold up. Can I get a... Right side, what? Left side, take this positive energy. Boom. Woo. Let me say that one more time. Do not allow your ego to get the best of you. Instead, allow yourself to get the best of your ego. And also, before we leave off, I want to say this one last quote one more time. Do not try to leave off with the last words in the argument, but yet try to leave off on a good note in the argument. Because I really want to stress to y'all, you don't know when the last time you can see that person may be. This is why you got to try to always leave off on a good note. Now, for those who watch this far, comment your favorite number or something. But I appreciate y'all so much. Remember, comment one thing you're grateful for. Let me know how you're doing in the comment section. Make sure everything's okay. Like, subscribe, comment, share. If you thoroughly enjoyed the content I brought you today, let me know if there's anything I could change to make my videos better. I'm open for all types of good and constructive criticism. And yeah, y'all have a beautiful, positive rest of your day. Remember to like, subscribe, do all that good stuff. We're on the road to inspire 1 million people to be positive, grateful, mindful, and overall the best version of themselves. Let's start this week. Let's start this Monday. Let's start this week off with some great positivity. Yes, sir. We're grateful to see Monday. I love you so much, my king or queen. You have a positive, amazing, beautiful rest of your day. Take this positive energy. I love you so much. For real. I appreciate you. Take this positive energy. Boom. Woo. JSO Positive signing out, my beautiful king or queen.